No injuries to talk about. Everybody's going to practice today, so we're good there. Look forward to the challenge of playing the Eagles. Good football team. Best record in the NFL, I believe, right now, and well-deserved. Coach Sirianni's done a good job. They've got good players. Their offense is tough. Brian does a heck of a job coordinating that thing, and then Sean does a great job with that defense. So they're playing good football right now. I look forward to coming here to Arrowhead and playing the game. It should be electric, and I know our fans will welcome them in. So anyways, with that, time's yours.
Andy, what is it like just going up against that organization you know so well?
Yeah, well, it's a well-run organization. Howie Roseman has done a nice job. I'm so close with a lot of those people there, so they do a nice job. Jeffrey Lurie starts with him. So, you're familiar with it, but again, once the game gets on, then it's the game. So you're not worried about all that stuff.
Coach, coming out of the Miami game, what were some of the focal points that you wanted to focus on to work on leading to Monday's game?
There were smaller things. I'm not going to get into all that, but I mean, we worked on a few things. So we have plenty of room to improve. So I've talked about that. You know, the penalties, we've got to continue to work on those, eliminate those. That's important.
Andy, you played against a number of the league's leading receivers, and no one's really had a big game against you. Other than guys at the back end of your defense are playing well, something you can put your finger on why that's been so effective?
I think it starts up front. You have a couple no names up there. They don't get a lot of credit, with Dana being one of them. And he's playing really good football right now. George is a year improved and playing real good football. So Nadi gets no credit, and he I don't think he wants the credit, but he didn't get any credit. He's a stout player inside. And then you had Charles. Charles is coming on, so he hasn't been here the whole time, but that's a nice addition to that mix.
My apologies.
You're fine.
You had obviously the bye week to obviously scout the Eagles. I know every year is slightly different, but is there anything that you see that is a difference between playing them in the Super Bowl and obviously preparing for them on Monday?
No, I wouldn't say there's much difference. Those receivers are still plenty good, and their quarterback's a good football player, as is the running back. So I know they had an injury to the tight end, so that would be a little bit different, but they've got good players in those spots. So, defensively, it's really basically the same unit. A couple of those guys are a little bit older, but you can't tell. So 91 and 55. Were there when I was there, and they are they seem to get better with age.
Coach, I know Chris is probably the first one to tell you he lost his cool in the game against Miami, but he's had several games without a sack. We're going to talk to him. You sense of frustration kind of building. He started so hot so quick, and now it's kind of gone dry. Is he getting a little frustrated?
You're going to ask him that, but I don't sense that. He knows that they slide the line to him. And so when I mention these other guys, and they chip him and all that. So when I mention these other guys, they're getting the benefit of him being doubled or chipped. And they're taking advantage of that. But Chris will get his when it's all said and done. He does so much for us, that attitude-wise and play-wise. So.
Kind of circling back to Adam's question about being able to take away the top receivers on the other team, Legarius has obviously been a big part of that. He's had seven flags over the last three games for either interference or holding. Is he kind of a feel like a marked guy right now just because he does play pretty physical?
Yeah, listen, I mean, I can't really answer that all the way. I wouldn't say he's marked, but I'll leave it at that.
Andy, when you look at first half and second half offensive numbers, is that something you chalk up to coincidence? Do you study the reasons why maybe there's a pretty big contrast there?
Just
your first half offensive numbers and your second half offensive numbers?
Yeah, I mean, listen, Frazier, I give credit to Frazier because he does all that. And he's on top of all that all the time. So, no, I can't tell you exactly why, but he probably could, but I'm not going to let him talk to you.
And one of the things that the Eagles, yourself, your guys' team, good teams win close games, and the Eagles have shown that a lot this year. Is there a characteristic among teams and maybe about them that allows them to survive a close one at the end?
Yeah, they're good. They're just good. I mean, they're well coached, and they've got good players. So, and they, you know, they have a culture there that dictates that. And so, good football team.
Andy, with the receivers, just the self-scouting that went with them during this bye week, you know, what have they learned more to try to just make themselves more available and everything that's going in to just try to make themselves better?
Yeah, they're getting better as we go. I know it's hard to see, but they're getting better. And, you know, we'll just see how it goes forward. I mean, anything I say isn't going to mean anything unless it, you know, they continue to improve. But we're seeing improvement. We just got to keep it going.
Coach, in the Super Bowl, Jalen rushed for 70 yards, setting a record. You guys won, but he was still a major threat making that game close. Is that the same thing that you have to be attuned to when you play them this time, his mobility and how he'll take off tonight?
And he threw the ball well, too. So, I mean, it was, yeah, you've got to look at all that. I mean, he's a strong kid, and that helps him in running. He's fast and strong, hard to bring down, strong in the pocket, and he's got a big arm. So he did well against us. Yeah, good player.
Coach, you know Jason, obviously, Travis. What have you made of what they've done for the growth of the game maybe in the past year with everything they've kind of been involved with off the field and leading into this game?
Yeah. Listen, ex-players have done a great job once they've gotten on the media. I mean, we know that. But to have the guys still playing and doing it and still maintaining the support of their teams doing it, that means that they're handling it the right way. And they're not putting coaches or players, you know, at risk. There's no threat there. That's when you get into trouble. So I would tell you it's a good example for guys. This will continue to grow with other teams. And so how you handle that, I think, is important. These guys have done a nice job with it. That part, I think, is the best example.
Couple more, guys.
Andy, with both teams coming off bye weeks, there's always hullabaloo about your team coming off the bye week. Is there something different about this year that with the offense looking really different?
No, I mean, I don't know. I get asked that because we've had success, and I don't know the reason. I mean, we just go play. I've had good players. I'm fortunate that way.
Coach, you've talked since you've been here about how all the games, so many of them come down, they're close, and at the end, and then, you know, magic card you've had here, Wade, is Pat's ability to go down the field so quick. How much of that is a unique trait, the ability to... You have to take chunks. We have 51 seconds in one timeout. He seems to be able to take those chunks and know the risk, reward, and when to do it. How special is that part of it?
Yeah. Surrender, there's no better weekend than this past one to look at how crazy the league is and how much parity there is in the league. The league is strive for that. Give every city an opportunity to be successful. And you saw it. I mean, this past weekend was wild. So to have somebody like Pat ends up being a big part of that. I mean, you start looking at the games that are determined by one score. It's ridiculous. Every year it increases and by number there. So to have somebody that can lead like Pat does and play the way he does, rally the guys around him, I think is important. Yeah.
Last one, Neil.
Coach,
Coach, how does having a week off for the guys, how does that affect them? And do you expect them to be fresher and feel better coming to practice?
Yeah, I think both teams would tell you yes. I mean, a little time off doesn't hurt the guys physically. So they, and most of them came back in good shape. They didn't, you know, they didn't just sit on the couch. They worked. So I made sure when they got back here, they could move around well. And you sometimes you worry about the big guys, but I thought our guys did a nice job with that. Yeah.
All right. Thank you.
Thanks.
Appreciate it.
Yep. Mm-hmm.